In this video, we're going to see limit points. Remember that if you want to support the channel, there are several ways for you to do so. You can either buy books on Amazon using our affiliate links that are all in the description of the video. You can also make small donations on Ko-fi. Or you can be a member of Patreon with a monthly membership that has a lot of benefits. Let's get to the definition of a limit point. We have a topological space X, so X with a topology, and a subset A. Given some element X in the space, we say that this element is a limit point of the set we are considering if every neighborhood of X, that is, every set U in the topology that contains X, intersects A in some point other than X. And this is the important part of the definition, because up to this point, the definition was very similar to an element belonging in the closure of a set. But now the thing is, we want the neighborhoods of X to intersect A in a point that's different from X itself. Let's write this definition now with symbols. We say that X belongs, and we usually call A prime, the set of limit points, if and only if, because it's the definition, every neighborhood of X, so that is every set in the topology that contains X, the intersection of U with A is different from zero, so it intersects A at some point other than X0. So we can write this as saying the intersection of U with A minus X is different from the empty set. And here is the difference between a set being in the limit point set and being in the closure set. The closure did not have this requirement of A minus the point itself. So let's see a few examples. If we consider the set 0, 1, for example, we know, let's call this A, then we know that A closure is the closed set 0, 1, and then every point in the closure will be a limit point. Because if I'm here, then there is no way that I can take an open interval and doesn't contain elements other than itself. So to see that one is a limit point, I would have to get all these open intervals that are neighborhoods of one. But every time I move to the left of one a bit, I'm immediately having infinite elements of my set A. So that proves that one is a limit point. And the same happens, for example, with zero. Every time I move a bit to the right of zero, I'm immediately adding infinite elements in this interval, but also every element inside of A, because of the same reason. We can also consider another set. What happens if we take, for example, 1 over n for n natural? So now, if here is 0 and 1, our set is the set of all these points, and obviously infinitely many more. So what we can prove is that 0 is a limit point of A, and that is again very simple. Every time I grab an open interval that contains 0, I'm obviously considering open intervals, because open intervals are the elements in the basis of the standard topology, which is the one I'm working with. Whenever, again, I move a bit to the right and I take the open interval like this, then I immediately have infinite elements here of the form 1 over n. So 0 is an element in the limit points of A. What about the elements of A itself? Well, if I take this 1 over n, then I can always find this open interval. Let's call it U. And for this open interval, U intersection A is only this point of the form 1 over n. And so with this, we have that U intersection A minus 1 over n is empty. And so it's not satisfying the definition of being an empty point, in which we required every neighborhood to have non-empty intersection with A minus the point we were considering. So what happens now when we change our topology? Well, it's essentially the same, so the reasoning is the same, but the limit points could change. For example, we can take again this very first one. When a is 0, 1. And we can think about Ru, so the real numbers with the upper limit topology. This is the one generated by all the sets of the form AB closed in B. So now I ask you, is 0 a limit point of A? Try and answer this yourself. Well, it is not. 0 is not an element in A prime. Why? Well, very simple. Minus 1, 0, but closing 0 is a neighborhood of 0. Because now we are considering the upper limit topology, so we are allowed to take intervals with a closed right extreme. And if we call this set U, then U intersection A minus 0, well, 0 wasn't in the set in the first place, this one is empty. And so 0 is not a limit point of A. Well, what happens, and I'm leaving this one as an exercise, what happens with 1? Is 1 a limit point of A? And is 1 a limit point of A on RL? That is the lower limit topology, remember, generated by these intervals. What happens in this situation? Well, now that we are sort of understanding the limit points, let's see a theorem. This theorem tells us that the closure of a set is the union of the set itself with the limit points. And the proof is very simple. We're going to do it by double inclusion. So first, let's do this one. Obviously, A was a subset of the closure of A, so we're not even going to consider this case. But what happens if A is in the set of the limit points? Well, then we know that for every neighborhood of X, that is for every element in the topology. So here we have to remember that X comes with a topology that contains X. U intersection A minus X. This is different from the empty set because it's a limit point. Well, then in particular, U intersection A is different from the empty set, and so because we have this for every neighborhood of X, the next is in the closure of A. Now let's do the other inclusion. So let's take an element X in the closure of A. If X was an element in A, then we already have what we wanted because it would be in this part of the union. So let's consider elements that are in the closure, but are not part of A. So what happens if X is not in A? Because X is in the closure of A, then we know that for every neighborhood of X, the intersection of U with A is different from the empty set. And so we may ask ourselves, okay, but how am I getting from this to this intersection with A minus X? Well, but remember that X is not an element in A. And so we have that A is equal to A minus X. And so this is equal to U intersection A minus X. And so we have that X is a limit point of A. And this proves the theorem, and so we finish the video.